What do you think is scarier? The idea that we are alone in the universe or the idea that we are in it? Why? That we are alone. Given how massive the universe is in space and time, the idea that Earth is the only place where any life form exists is unsettling. Everyone seems to be assuming that other life means humanoid or intelligent. To me, it just means any life form. Carbon-based or made of element unknown to our galaxy. There has to be something else. The idea that we are alone. It gives me a feeling of loneliness and that there is not as much out there to look for. Existence would not be as interesting. Next best thing is to shoot bacteria into space and hope it hits something, then we will have created aliens. Would they still be aliens if they originated from Earth? Depends if they claim citizenship there. Mathematically there should be life. I think it would be far more frightening that we are alone. It would indicate there was something very weird going on. The idea that we are alone. Because it would imply that our existence is winning the astronomical lottery and this is all we are trying to do with it. Earth have had a couple billion years, sir, and the best they could come up with was making memes about a gorilla who was shot. Oh. That we are alone. It would give credence to the simulation theory. Given the number of stars being circled by planets that we can see from Earth, let alone the rest of the universe, the odds are laughably small that on one of those distant planets the same building blocks didn't exist. This planet is not unique. But simulation theory is the least scary explanation for why we are alone. To me, it's actually the most comforting explanation, because it means there exists superior intelligence and it somehow cares about our existence. Even if only tangentially, the more scary slash depressing explanations are. 1. We are the first. It means we're screwing up a very unlikely opportunity. 2. We are one of many, but the only one right now. It means civilizations like ours are all doomed to collapse, and extinction egg the great filter is ahead of us. I have recurring dreams, nightmares, of an alien invasion. It usually follows some kind of theme where there are instantaneous global sightings and amped up military engagement slash reconnaissance to determine the potential threat. I live close to a large airbase BTW. I'll see it pop up on the TV, and whenever my family and I go outside we will spot a group of them. It's usually just a blip, like they are turning their cloaking devices on and off. But it's one of the most terrifying feelings I've ever experienced. Sheer terror and panic grip us, and we all confirm what we saw. Nothing I've experienced in real life has filled me with that type of dread. For some reason I'm always convinced there is nowhere to hide, and not knowing what is the exact threat gives me a feeling of futility slash helplessness. There is nothing we can do to stop them from having their way with us. Sometimes it feels like they just start bombing the whole planet at once or something. Earthquakes and intense weather suddenly appear, and the horizon just shuts down with either black or gray walls like lights being turned off in a long hallway. Till the darkness closes in on me. At the end it always feels like there was something we could have done to prevent it from happening, but we procrastinated slash didn't care, and that's why the aliens came. A few times the sky literally tore open, and what felt like angels slash demons slash interdimensional beings just came spewing through. Like projectile vomit through a wet paper bag. Not much I can remember following those instances. Just sheer terror. Credit to N. By Stephen King. I'm sure reading King's and Lovecraft's works plus watching Hollywood have influenced these dreams slash nightmares. But I still can't help but feel like being alone in the universe is worse. It seems like the aliens come because we fucked up the planet and they use it as an intergalactic sort of pit stop. They got tired of letting us destroy nature or something. It's not like they were evil, it was like they had some sort of grand scheme way beyond what some hairless chimps could comprehend. I was reading your description and just thinking this guy should write a book. Then I got to the shout out to Stephen King and H.P. Lovecraft and it all made sense. You're a great writer, BTW. You should explore that if you have not already. If you have any stories, please share them in the comments section below. I think the scariest thing is that if an asteroid hit Earth right now and destroyed everything, nothing that we know of will recognize any record of anything that ever happened on Earth. There will be nothing to account for the loss of Earth. So if there's nothing out there to do that, then it's like Earth never existed at all. Scary. Actually, we sent out proof of our existence on probes, https. /endpointmwikipedia.org/wiki/pioneer_plaque. We sent into outer space in the hopes alien life might find them. They have some cool stuff like a star map to Earth, and recordings of various humans. So NASA gave the aliens directions to come and invade Earth. Way to go, NASA. Way to go. /S. The aliens have realized that NASA was dumb enough to give them directions to us, so they realize we aren't worth messing with. Well, the idea that we'll never know. There are lots of paradoxes and problems regarding aliens. If they are there at all, have they developed technology advanced enough to create electromagnetic signals? And if yes, why we haven't seen any signs throughout the visible universe? Our civilization can be easily spotted for everyone in a California 110 Li radio us with radio telescope, and we can't spot anything in billions of light years around. On the other hand, we have animals on Earth, dated hundreds of millions of years, and they haven't evolved into space dwellers. Honestly, it doesn't matter if we are or not alone. We'll never reach to the stars unless we find out how to break laws of physics. I am pretty sure everyone alive right now will never know. Maybe it is just universally not possible to travel such long distances in space. Maybe all other species do not even want to do that. Maybe, all we can do is wonder. Cause we ain't at discovering new planets and life forms in my lifetime. That we aren't. If we are alone, then we are the best and worst of the universe. I don't want to run into a species worse than us. Valid point. Also great filters. Hopefully when we've beaten the odds and have managed to secure a place in a hostile universe. Great video by Kirstja Sagd. We haven't beaten the odds. We'd need to at least become a multi-planetary species for that. One asteroid could wipe us out at the moment. Tell me, Op. Have you read the Three Body Problem series? Yes. Before reading the series, I would think being alone would be scarier. The dark forest theory makes the existence of alien civilizations far scarier. Alone. It's theoretically impossible for us to be alone. But if we're the first/last thinking life forms in the universe, that's a depressing thought. Cause that means someday, the last human being will die out, and that will be the end of all progress. Sure, life will go on. But would another species step up and do better than us? Can they? Will they? I guess the not knowing is the worst part of it. Theoretically extremely unlikely. Not impossible. I mean, I'm no expert, but I'm pretty sure Earth and mankind becoming the way they are was also an extremely unlikely occurrence. Very much this. There had to be heavy bombardments. Eukaryotic evolution. Snowball Earths. Ice ages. Plate tectonics and retard frog squirrels. Just for us to be here. The idea that it matters. The idea that regardless of either possibility, there is no saving us from ourselves. True. That we are alone. The thought that Shrek exists somewhere and would kindly accept us in his swamp in the time of a major catastrophe gives me a good night's sleep. The idea we aren't. Basically, any time two entities come into contact, there is some kind of power struggle, and the loser is either subjugated or eliminated. The only chance for peace is a coincidental situation where both parties are at the same power, but roughly speaking, to where the struggle is known to be too damaging to all parties such that it should be avoided. I don't think either of those outcomes is scary. Reality is what it is. Getting upset over it isn't going to change anything. That's no more scary than the fact that I can't flap my arms and fly to the moon. I don't think the reality is scary, but the idea, the way the mind can spin a narrative and cause anxiety about something that is inherently unlikely. Reality, with the vastness of the universe, the existence of other life forms is almost a certainty. They are most likely limited in travel, as we are, and will never make contact. They are as clueless to our existence as we are to this. Not scary. Idea. Aliens. They are going to invade our planet. Full on Independence Day. If they exist. That opens us up to the probability of every ridiculous sci-fi movie scenario about alien encounters. If we had contact. I doubt they would invade. Why do so? You can get any material fats here on Earth on any other planet. Without risking losers. I think they would be missionary type. Exploring space and looking for other intelligent life. alone because some astronomical event must have destroyed that civilization. It is only some time until it eventually happens to us. Yao are assuming there was another civilization to begin with. True. But it would be pretty unlikely that life only started on our planet. Sure, there's many conditions that need to be met. But there are an infinite amount of planets. There has to be at least another that sustained or sustains life. Not infinite. Definitely an extremely large number. But not infinite. The idea that we are alone, because that would mean no other hospitable planets exist in the universe, and when the Earth finally blows up, or whatever, then that is the end of life in the universe. You mean when we overpopulate and destroy the Earth in the next 20 years? I agree. Neither is scary, because if we are alone, then we have nothing to worry about. If we are not, then the sheer vastness of space is a pretty good indicator that we are not likely to ever make contact with another intelligent species. I find it more depressing knowing that there are so many galaxies and planets out there, that there must be billions of strange and exotic places that we'll never see or explore. We are pretty much confined to our own solar system, unless we develop a technology to skip across time and space, which is scary to imagine. True. How amazing would it be to planet hop? Forget Europe. I am vacationing in another galaxy. The idea of being alone. That we are alone. For sure. Now, not saying that is scary, but it's scarier than knowing there are aliens, because if there's one, then suddenly the odds of more goes up. And given the scale, the possibilities are endless. We could come across aliens that have cures for all diseases and answers to all our questions about the universe. All given to us in the space of a couple days, saving us centuries of scientific research and advancement. This is equally as likely as a predatory alien species that tries to eat us, but generally, when a civilization advances, certainly to the level of space travel, the civilization become more and more peaceful. I think about the ruins of ancient civilizations on other planets, and how absolutely fascinating it would be to explore them. That would be amazing. Mathematically, we should not be alone. There are too many stars in too many galaxies across a seemingly infinite universe that has already existed for billions of years. So, if we are alone, there has to be a reason for it. And that reason must be terrifying. A wave that wipes out a city is terrifying. A fire that kills everything in a forest is terrifying. We don't have a word to describe the unfathomable horror of confronting the reason why life does not exist in the universe. Even more worrying, if this force has wiped out all life in the universe, for what reason has it left us? The idea that we are alone is way scarier. The idea that we could go extinct in a couple hundred years and be the end of intelligent life in the universe is depressing. I am comforted by the idea that there is more out there than just us. Thanks for watching the video. Please like and subscribe for more content.